God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, and the mountains quake with their surging. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. Let us bow our heads in prayer, asking upon us the Lord's blessings as we begin our worship this morning. Almighty God, our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you and we praise you for granting us one more opportunity to come together like this as family, to sit around your feet and to worship you. We strongly feel your presence in the midst of us. Continue to be with us, Lord. Guard us from any distraction, that we might focus our attention on the face of the Lord Jesus Christ and look deeply into his eyes and receive his favor this morning. We commit ourselves the rest of the time into your loving hand. Bless us, Lord. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we humbly pray. Amen. Now the opening hymn will be played. Please sing along with the words.
Thank you.
Now I request our brother Ravi Kumar Edwin to bring greetings and announcements.
We greet each one of you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and invite you for the online morning worship service. Following persons are celebrating their birthdays and wedding anniversaries in the coming week. On 15th, Mrs. Sita Margadhar Rose and Mr. Anand Lincoln Victor. On 19th, Mr. Johnson Balakumar and Mrs. Malathi J. Christina Mathias. Wedding anniversary on 15th, Mr. and Mrs. Roshan Victor Raj. Wish you all a happy birthday and a happy wedding anniversary. Thank God for all His mercies poured on each one of you throughout the last year. And pray God to guard and protect you in the new year and fulfill all your needs. And His presence should go with each one of you. God bless you. Beracah Beacon will be sent through WhatsApp this evening. Please take time to read and be blessed. Continue to pray for the healing touch of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ on our country to stop the spreading of the coronavirus. People's life should be saved and church should be open for worshipping the Lord together in the sanctuary. Thank you. God bless you.
Friends, we enjoyed the singing and now is the time to go to God in prayer again. Even as I read in the beginning from Psalm 46, where it says, God is our refuge and strength. And it ends with this word, the Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. So with this in mind, let's go to God in prayer. Friends, as we all know, the coronavirus is spreading very, very fast. And it is sad to say, it even claimed the very life of some of our loved ones. In the past week, we lost our dear brother Isaac Manogaram, a member of the Emmanuel Methodist Church, who has visited our church along with a team of his home children, and he has now gone to be with the Lord. Let us pray for the bereaving family, his wife and his two children and the children in the steps home. We thank God for the healing of the Kingslins, our neighbors. They have come back from the hospital. They are recuperating. Kindly continue to remember them in your prayers. Let us also remember our own members who are ailing. Let's remember Auntie Ratna Sundar Singh. Let's pray for Mrs. Swaroop as they are undergoing treatment. May God's strength be of their portion. Shall we go to God in prayer? Let's pray. Almighty God, our loving Heavenly Father, where else can we go, O Lord, except coming unto You? You are our Heavenly Father. You love us even as a mother loves her children. Gracious Master, we thank You for Your love towards us. The love that sent the only Son, to die on the cross in order to make all of us the sons of God. We thank you for the sacrifice of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ on the cross of Calvary in order to redeem us. He so sacrificially died for us so that we could become the children of God, so that we could become the members of His family, so that we could become the citizens of His kingdom. Gracious Master, we thank you for the ministry of the Holy Spirit, who graciously is residing in all the believing and trusting hearts. We thank you for His comfort. We thank you for the consolation that He brings to us. We thank you, God, for reminding us through the Holy Spirit your wonderful promises when we go through trials and tribulations. We worship you, the triune God, the three in one, holy God, loving God, almighty and powerful God. We fall prostrate before your awesome presence. Lord, we adore you. We magnify your holy name. And Lord, we plead with you that you would listen to our prayers this morning. We very particularly this morning pray for this particular home. Lord, whatever the need might be, even as they listen to your voice and join the worship along with the believers all over in different places, Lord, we pray you will send the spirit of comfort and joy and fill this home. We do not know what they need. We pray for the head of the family. We pray for the man of this home. Be with him, Lord. Grant him your wisdom and courage in all these trying situations. May he be the leader, the head of this home. We pray for the woman, the wife of this home. Be with her as she has given herself for the welfare of this home. We pray, O Lord, that you would grant her all grace and compassion from above. Grant her the physical strength that she needs as she goes about cleaning the home, leading the children, and taking care of her husband. We pray you will bless her in her ministry. We pray for the children, the young ones in this family, O God. We pray you will bless the little children who are worshipping along with us this morning. Even though they may not understand all these concepts, we pray for them that one day this would come towards their help. And Lord, we pray for those who are sick in this family. Be with them, heal them, And Lord, that they might be able to join us once we reopen the church. Lord, we pray for all the youngsters as they spend their time before the computer from morning till evening. Grant them your grace. Grant them the physical strength. Remove all the strains from their eyes. And Lord, bless them with good health. And also, Lord, we pray that they might understand that the work is not the ultimate goal of life. Seeking after the kingdom of God and giving themselves up to the Lord alone will bless them. We pray for the seniors of our church. And Lord, even with all their physical disabilities, physical limitations, as they sit before the computer, the television, hold the mobile phone in their hands, Lord, we pray for them. Grant them your strength. Grant them the boldness to face life as it comes. Give them your strength, O God, for them. Make them a blessing to every home wherever they reside. And Lord, we pray for a Tippett ministry. We pray for every member in that little tenement. Lord, as they worship you this morning, be with them and bless them, O God. Lord, we also pray for those who are celebrating their birthdays during this week. We pray for Mrs. Celine Davis. We pray for Mr. Lincoln. We pray for Mr. Bala. And we pray for Mrs. Malati as they all enter, O Lord, this year into a new year. We pray that you would bless every one of them with your power, with your unction, and with your grace. And we also pray for Mr. and Mrs. Roshan Victor Raj as they celebrate their wedding anniversary. We pray that you will bless them too, wherever they are, O God. We pray your blessing hand to be upon them and bless them. We pray for our country and all the countries of the world as the governments here in Tamil Nadu and all over the world as they are trying to control the spread of this virus. Lord, it is ultimately you. You alone have the power to destroy the spread of the virus itself. Gracious Master, make your children, those who are worshipping this very morning throughout the world, confirm your word to them. Perform a miracle before their eyes. And Lord, those who are watching these programs from various places, through various churches, Lord, we pray your clean, pure, living word will touch the unbelievers and they might become your children by accepting you as their Savior and Lord. We submit the rest of the time into your loving care. Bless us, Lord, for we pray in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us all join together in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Today's Bible reading is taken from the book of Joshua, chapter 1, verses from 1 to 18. Chapter 1, verses from 1 to 18. Now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spake unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, Moses, my servant is dead. Now therefore arise, go over this Jordan, thou and all this people, unto the land which I do give to them, even to the children of Israel. Every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses, from the wilderness and this Lebanon, even unto the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and unto the great sea, toward the going down of the sun, shall be your coast. There shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee, nor forsake thee. Be strong and of a good courage, for unto this people shalt thou divide for an inheritance the land which I swear unto their fathers to give them. Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper whithersoever thou goest. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. Have not I commanded thee? Be strong and of a good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with thee whithersoever thou goest. Then Joshua commanded the officers of the people, saying, pass through the host, and command the people, saying, prepare you victuals, for within 3 days ye shall pass over this Jordan, to go into possess the land which the Lord your God giveth you to possess it. And to the Reubenites, and to the Gadites, and to half the tribe of Manasseh, spake Joshua, saying, remember the word which Moses, the servant of the Lord, commanded unto, saying, the Lord your God hath given you rest, and hath given you this land. Your wives, your little ones, and your cattle shall remain in the land which Moses gave you on this side Jordan, but ye shall pass before your brethren armed, all the mighty men of valor, and help them, until the Lord have given your brethren rest, as he hath given you, and they also have possessed the land which the Lord your God giveth them. Then ye shall return unto the land of your possession, and enjoy it which Moses the Lord's servant gave you on this side Jordan toward the sun rising. And they answered Joshua, saying, all that thou commandest us, we will do, and whithersoever thou sendest us, we will go. according as we hearkened unto Moses in all things, so will we hearken unto thee. Only the Lord thy God be with thee, as he was with Moses. Whosoever he be that doth rebel against thy commandment, and will not hearken unto thy works in all that thou commandest him, he shall be put to death. Only be strong and of a good courage. May God add blessings to these verses.
In the year 2016, when the then Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Mrs. J. Jayalalitha, died, the newspapers announced and said, because of her death, there is a vacuum created in the Tamil Nadu politics. Of course, this is true. When someone dies, there is a vacuum created, and it is very difficult to fill that vacuum. This is even true in our own families. When our loved ones pass away, we feel the vacuum, the void. But as Christians, we have the blessed Holy Spirit, and his consolation and the hope that we have would sustain us even through this vacuum. The book of Joshua, chapter 1, verse 1. It starts with the announcement of the death of their great leader, Moses. Let me read it for you. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses' aide. Yes, God wanted Joshua to rise up and to fill this vacuum and to be the leader of Israel from then on. What kind of a leader Moses was? Deuteronomy chapter 34 and verse 10, it says, since then, no prophet has risen in Israel like Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face, who did all those miraculous signs and wonders the Lord sent him to do in Egypt, to Pharaoh and to all his officials and to his whole land. For no one has ever shown the mighty power or performed the awesome deeds that Moses did in the sight of all Israel. Such a kind of a leader Moses was. And when the Lord asked Joshua to take his place, he was shivering in his shoes. Now that Moses is dead, Israelites are left without a leader. They were standing on a no man's land. And let's look at the conversations that are there in the first chapter. Joshua chapter 1 has three conversations. We will go on to meditate on all these three conversations. Moses, my servant, is dead. Now then, you and all these people get ready to cross the Jordan River into the land I am about to give to them, to the Israelites. I will give you every place where you set your foot, as I promised Moses. Hearing this, Joshua was frightened. But friends, all along, as he assisted Moses in the journey, he learned many, many things. The Lord was preparing him to take the leadership of these Israelites. He knows the importance of trusting God. He knows the importance of prayer. He also realized how these Israelites were changing their minds. On some occasions, they would applaud and praise Moses. On the next moment, they will murmur against him. So God was preparing Joshua all these years. And now God speaks to Joshua. In verse 1, the Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses' aide. And in the second verse, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now then, you and all these people get ready to cross the Jordan River. He commissions Joshua to lead the people and to cross the river Jordan. And in verse 3, he promises, I will give you every place where you set your foot, as I promised Moses. Wherever you go, whatever you claim, I will give it to you. And comes the grand verse 5. No one will be able to stand up against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. The Lord grants him his own promise. I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. And from verses 6 to 9, he says, be strong and courageous, because you will lead these people to inherit the land I swore to their forefathers to give them. Again, for the second time, he says, be strong and very courageous. So friends, when the Lord asks us to do a task, he will also will equip us with his presence. The Lord says, I will be with you. This is not the first time that Joshua had heard this promise. I'm sure Moses, as they both were walking together, definitely would have shared his experience in the mountain desert, in the burning bush, when God appeared and asked him to go and be a leader and lead the people out of Egypt, which is recorded in Exodus chapter 3 and verse 12. Exodus chapter 3 and verse 12. What the Lord said to Moses. And God said, I will be with you. But before that, but Moses said to God, who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and bring the Israelites out of Egypt? To his contention, the Lord replies, and God said, I will be with you, and this will be the sign to you that it is I who have sent you. When you have brought the people out of Egypt, you will worship God on this mountain. So, Joshua very well knew that God had kept his promise. And God's presence was always with Moses. And so now, he is there to respond to the call of God. Yes, it's a fearful and awesome responsibility. From verses 6 to 9 in Joshua chapter 1, we read, be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from it to the right or to the left, that you may be successful wherever you go. Of course, this promise comes with a condition. Condition of keeping and obeying the commandments of God. Yes, there are many battles to be won. There are many cities to be conquered. There are many kings to be dethroned. It is a Herculean and a Himalayan task. Friends, can we apply this promise that is in chapter 1 and verse 5? I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Can we apply this promise for us in our day-to-day life? Yes, we are also called to be engaged in spiritual warfare. In our lives, there are many battles to be won. We have to fight our sinful nature. There are many cities to be conquered. We have many things to conquer in our lives. Those fleshly desires, ungodly expressions that are listed out in God's word, we have to conquer them. And we have to dethrone many kings, yes, other than the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ. We have many kings, little kings, ruling from our hearts. We need to dethrone them. It is a spiritual warfare. We have to go forward. We have to take our family and other believers along. And so everyone is a leader. So, let us not give up. Let us claim this promise, even though it was given more than 3,500 years ago. It is living even for us today. He says, be courageous, be strong, because I am with you. In the scriptures, friends, there are many places and examples as to how people in their own days claimed this promise and became strong and courageous. As I said earlier, Moses experienced it. You read it in Exodus chapter 3. We see Gideon. We read it in the book of Judges chapter 6 and verse 16. A judge, now a king. King David claimed this. A very familiar passage for all of us. Psalm 23 and verse 4 it says, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. This is a testimony of David. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 43 and verse 2. What it says, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have summoned you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be blamed. The flames will not set you ablaze, because I am with you. And what about the New Testament? Apostle Paul, he claimed when he was feeling lonely, when there is a huge task before him, he claims in Acts chapter 18 and verse 10. Acts chapter 18 and verse 10. What does he say? One night the Lord spoke to Paul in a vision. Do not be afraid. Keep on speaking. Do not be silent, for I am with you, and no one is going to attack and harm you, because I have many people in this city. We can go on and on and on, finding so many examples of people who have claimed this promise in all the critical moment in their lives. When they felt weak, when they felt discouraged, these promises became their source of strength. Again, the book of Matthew, chapter 28, verses 18 to 20, we read, there is a task kept before every Christian. Go out into the world and proclaim the gospel. How is it possible, Lord? The world is so hostile to Christian teaching and preaching. How can I be a missionary? How can I be an evangelist? How can I be a witness? But along with that comes the promise. Be strong and courageous, because I am with you, not only yesterday and tomorrow and today, but till the end of the age. And one final reminder in the book of Hebrews, chapter 13 and verse 5. A very familiar verse that we always quote, but it has a background. Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 5. It says, keep your lives free from the love of money and be content with what you have, because God has said, never will I leave you, never will I forsake you. So we say with confidence, the Lord is my helper, I will not be afraid. What can man do to me? It is during the financial crisis. The Lord here commands, do not encourage the love of money in your heart. Get free of this lust and desire. And immediately he says, don't ask what will I get, O Lord. He says, my presence will be with you. Never will I leave you nor forsake you. The Lord is my helper. And so, as we go through these verses, the Lord's presence was promised. And very shortly and briefly, let us look at the second conversation that Joshua has with the leaders. The beauty, friends, of Joshua's obedience is he immediately responds. He could be wavering, he might be fearful in his heart, and slowly he could be putting off the call of God to him. I will do it tomorrow, Lord. Let me keep on praying, and one day I will get up and rise up and lead these people, he could have said, or he could have did it, he could have done it. But in verse 10 we read, so Joshua ordered the officers of the people. He said, go through the camp and tell the people, get your supplies ready. 3 days from now, that is the limit that he set. In 3 days' time, we will cross the Jordan and you will enter into your own land. He did not postpone. He said immediately, yes, God, I will go with your presence accompanying me. He immediately acted on the promise. No delay, no tactics of any delay. As someone said, delayed obedience is equivalent to disobedience. He immediately obeyed. Whatever the task that is before us, friends, again the word comes to us, be strong, be courageous, because the Lord of the universe, the one who created the universe, is with you. And finally, we see the third conversation that Joshua has with the 2.5 tribes of the Israelites. We see this from verse 12 to 18. Let's not go back into all the history because time is limited. There was a promise given by Moses to the 2.5 tribes. Who are they? Reubenite, Gadite, and half the tribe of Manasseh. They are the sons of Joseph, Ephraim and Manasseh. And wherever they were staying, these 2.5 tribes, they said, this is the place Moses has promised us. we will stay back. And this was the context in which Joshua was speaking to them. Said, it is all right. You leave your kith and kin. The Lord your God is giving you rest and has granted you this land. Your wives, your children, and your livestock may stay in the land that Moses gave you east of the Jordan. But all your fighting men, fully armed, must cross over ahead of your brothers. You leave all your possessions, your family members. But all the young men, those who can fight, carry the arms, come along with me. We have to fight for the rest of the 9.5 tribes. They are all your own brothers and sisters. A very crucial decision that Joshua and even the 2.5 tribes had to take. Is Israel going to be divided? Will they go to help? Will they also murmur against Joshua? No. What is the reply? Verse 16 and 17. Then they answered Joshua, whatever you have commanded us, we will do. And wherever you send us, we will go. What a beautiful example of obeying their leader, obeying a godly leader. They found out the godliness, the honesty, the faithfulness, these qualities in the life of Joshua. That's why they say, whatever you have commanded us, we will do. And wherever you send us, we will go. Friends, what an example of cooperation and unity they expressed. How do we apply this for us today? What is our responsibility towards our fellow believers? Are we ready to stand on their behalf? There are many of our own brothers and sisters in other parts of the country, of our own country, India. They are being persecuted for the sake of their faith. Because they say Jesus is the Lord, they are persecuted. Are we ready to stand with them? Are we ready to pray for them and work shoulder to shoulder to lessen their burden? And this is why we pray for the missionaries and the believers in the northern India. So 4 times this chapter says, be strong and courageous. In verse 6, verse 7, verse 9, and 19. And this is the theme of this chapter. Be strong and courageous. The same call comes to us, to all of us, to go on with our life, even though there is a vacuum in our lives, to provide for the family, to fulfill God's great commission. It seems a difficult task. I can't do it, Lord. The reply comes from the Lord. I am with you. Be strong and courageous. Get going, for I am with you. When your heart is down, when you feel you cannot move any forward, remember the promise of God. Rely upon His promise, because He already fulfilled and will fulfill the promise that He gave to His children. Amen. Let us bow our heads in prayer and receive the Lord's benediction. Almighty God, our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time, a time to worship you, a time to glorify and adore your wonderful presence. And Lord, receive instructions from your word. We pray, with the strength that you give, we move on to do our day-to-day duties. We thank you for your presence with us. Help us to be conscious that we are strong and we should be courageous. So, O Lord, we pray that your blessing to rest upon this home and with all the ones who worshipped along with us. We give you all the glory and honor, and we offer this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's receive the Lord's benediction. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the fellowship and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with all of us, with every member of this hall and throughout the church, both now and forevermore. Amen.